Dr. Khan, explain to me the difference between a veneer and aluminium. You know, basically cosmetic dentistry to make a person look better. That, as you mentioned at the beginning, there are three major ways of why what the teeth are doing. It's the function to chew, it's the looking good, and what was the other one?
And the speech.
The what? The speech, yeah, speech, the speech. Yeah. All right, good. They're looking good. They're looking good. Boy, is it important. We wouldn't have plastic surgeons if it wouldn't be important, would we? And I have noticed that lots of dentists, the best plastic surgeon can't do much without a dentist. And quite often I've noticed that dentists do a better plastic surgery than plastic surgeons. Because if a person loses a lot of teeth, and then he, because of it, he loses bones because they when the teeth are gone, the bones shrink, and all of a sudden he looks like a dried out tomato, and then he goes for Botox when all he needed was keep his teeth in the first place. Is that true?
Yes.
Kind of, right? So,
all right.
So anyway, let's talk about veneers and luminaires. What's the difference between those two? Because most of us don't know. And we all know they fall into cosmetic dentistry. We all know there's some type of clip-on on your teeth. I call them clip-on teeth, you know, like clip-on fingernails. But give me the lowdown on it.
Okay. It's about the cosmetic dentistry, and people they are concerned about the aesthetics these days so much. And so they develop some kind of dental treatment for the cosmetic reason. We call this a veneer or luminous. Both of them is using adhesive dentistry. We glue something on the tooth to make the teeth look white and straight. And there's a few different techniques. So when we make the veneers, we have to shape the tooth just a little bit, very minimum. We shape the tooth so we can glue the veneer on the top of the tooth so make the teeth look white or straight. The luminous is usually they don't have to be shape the tooth. We just glue on the natural healthy tooth to minimize, to avoid the tooth reduction.
But so basically, when you say shape the tooth or tooth reduction, what you mean is you don't need to grind it down.
Yeah, we don't have to grind down.
And you said in another video that grinding down a tooth, if it's relatively healthy in the first place, is not a good thing. You want to avoid it. So does that mean a luminaire in some reason, some ways, because it's thinner and you don't need to grind the tooth down, is better?
Yes, if it's possible, it's better to don't grind the healthy teeth. But the disadvantage of this is limited the changing of the teeth. It's a very limited area we can use for this. So usually when you suggest for the front teeth, we suggest the veneer because the purpose of the veneer is the cosmetic reason.
Right.
So there's more we can straighten the teeth or change the shape with the veneer. So we usually suggest the veneer to change the shape of the tooth.
I see. So to me, from what you explained here, let me summarize that, whether I understood that right. A veneer and a luminaire more or less are the same thing, but maybe a little bit of a different brand, kind of like one shoe which is thinner with a thinner sole, one shoe is with a higher sole, and the one which is thinner, you can glue it right on the tooth. So maybe if you have pretty good and nice looking teeth, but you want them slightly longer or slightly different color, more beautiful, then that might do the trick. And if there's more fixing to do, that they're more crooked or whatever it may be, you might have to go with a veneer, which is the same thing, just a little thicker layer of clip-on, and you might have to grind a little more.
That's correct. Yeah, so veneer, we can have more room to fix the tooth, because we grind the teeth. Yeah, but luminaire is a little more limited. So But there's an advantage that we don't have to grind our teeth. That's
right.
It's a good advantage.
Yes. Right. So for instance, if a person has a couple, two, maybe three, whatever, crooked teeth in front, you know, whichever way they're crooked, and he wants to straighten them out because that's ugly. He could maybe do it with orthodontic work if the teeth basically are in good shape, maybe, wear the braces for a few months or a year or whatever, and you do orthodontic work, right?
That's right.
Or he would use a set of veneer where you grind the teeth and then patch on what's it, and boom, within a couple, two, three, 4 hours, whatever the work takes, give or take, he is done and has the type of teeth he wanted.
Yes.
But a luminaire for this crooked teeth would probably not do the trick because then the teeth would still be crooked.
Yeah, a little bit like that.
A little bit like that.
Because, yeah, we cannot change that much with aluminium because we don't grind the teeth.
Got it. All right. Well, good. And let me ask you, so basically, a patient shouldn't concern himself about luminaire veneer. The dentist will tell him which kind to use.
Yeah, the patient needs a consultation first and they have to pick the right one, which one is a better choice for the patient.
Right. And more or less the price on those things is more or less the same anyway, give or take?
If we talk about the price, you can say it's about the same price.
Okay. Yeah, right. So basically
the price, the factor is which one is the more benefit to the patient. You have to decide which one can be, yeah.
And so it looks to me that it's a pure dentist decision and people shouldn't worry because, you know, they see advertising, luminous, because it's a very big company which makes them, right? So people, I'm sure they sometimes come to you and say, give me luminous. And they probably, and that's why I ask you the question, they really have no clue, you know, why, where, what. And so in the end, it's more or less the same. You need to look at what you need to achieve. And then the dentist decides there's no price difference. I love it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.